Hey everyone, and welcome to another deep dive. Today we're tackling something that everyone can relate to. We're going to look at how to talk about being sick.
You know, it's funny. Even if you're pretty good at English, sometimes it can be tricky to find the right words when you don't feel well.
Yeah, for sure. It's like there's a whole other vocabulary list just for feeling under the weather.
Exactly.
So we found this article that breaks down 18 key words, and we're going to take a deep dive into them. So whether you need to talk to a doctor or just tell your friend why you're not coming to that party, this deep dive is for you.
It's really all about feeling confident and comfortable explaining how you feel.
I like it. So let's start with the basics. Symptoms.
Right, the signs that tell us something might be off.
And I think we should start with one that we all know. Fever.
Yeah, everyone knows what it feels like to have a fever.
To be burning up.
Yeah, but as this article points out, it's more than just feeling hot.
It's like having a high temperature.
Yeah, a higher than normal body temperature.
Yeah, which usually means your body's fighting something.
An infection or something like that. And speaking of annoying things, the article also talks about coughing.
Okay, but isn't coughing sometimes a good thing?
Well, yeah, sometimes it is.
Like, it helps you clear your airways.
Totally, it helps get rid of stuff that's irritating your lungs.
But I guess when it just won't stop.
Then it's a problem.
Yeah, then it's not so fun.
And then there's fatigue.
Oh, yeah.
Not just feeling tired.
Like, I need a nap tired.
Yeah, but that feeling of being completely wiped out.
Yeah, like you have zero energy.
Right, total exhaustion.
And of course, there's the classic runny nose.
Ugh, the worst.
And sore throat.
The trifecta.
It's like we're describing the common cold already.
Right, and then the article goes on to talk about different types of illnesses, starting with the ones we all know. The flu, cold, and allergies.
Usual suspects. But then it talks about infection, which can be a little confusing.
Yeah, because a lot of people think infection is only when you have, like, a cut.
And it gets infected.
But it's really any time those bad little microorganisms, the bacteria or viruses,
get inside your body.
Exactly. They invade and start multiplying.
Yeah.
The article also talks about asthma, which affects your breathing.
Making it hard to breathe.
Exactly. Welcome back. We're ready to dive back into all those useful words for talking about illnesses.
You know, one thing I really like about this article is that it doesn't just give you the definitions.
It helps you actually use the words.
Exactly. Like in real life, because sometimes you know a word, but you're not sure how to actually say it.
And that's where the article's tips come in handy. Like one of the things it says is to be specific when you're describing your symptoms.
Instead of saying, I feel bad.
Yeah. Which doesn't tell us much.
Right. You can say, I have a sore throat.
And a headache.
That way, whoever you're talking to, they can actually understand what's going on.
And it can really help the doctor, right?
Totally. Because they need all the information to figure out what's wrong.
And the article also says that if someone's telling you about their symptoms, don't be afraid to ask questions.
Like to make sure you understand.
Yeah. Because sometimes people use words that you might not know.
Like, what does nausea mean?
Exactly.
Or what does that rash look like?
Right. So asking questions shows that you care and that you're really trying to understand.
Okay, this next tip is really fun. The article suggests role-playing.
To practice the words.
Yeah, so you can imagine yourself at the doctor's office.
Or talking to a friend.
And you can just try using the words in a safe space.
So that when you need to use them in real life, you feel more comfortable.
I love that. And there's even a little quiz.
To test yourself.
Yeah. So they give you sentences with missing words, and you have to use the vocabulary from the article to fill in the blanks.
Like, she stayed home from work because she had a blank and a blank.
And we know the answer is runny nose and a cough.
Exactly. And beyond just learning the words, the article talks about how language can actually help us feel better.
Because when you can explain how you feel.
It can make you feel more in control.
Right, and it helps you get the right treatment.
And it also helps you understand what's happening in your body.
So you can take better care of yourself.
And as language learners, it's a great feeling to be able to express ourselves clearly, especially when it comes to our health.
It's like you're adding another tool to your language toolbox. Welcome back, everyone. We've made it to the final part of our deep dive into all these amazing words about health and illness.
I feel like after learning all these words, I can finally explain exactly how I'm feeling.
Me too. It's like I can actually have a real conversation with my doctor now.
Right. Instead of just like pointing and making strange noises.
But the article makes a good point. This is just a starting point, right?
Totally. There are so many words related to health and illness out there, and we'll probably never stop learning new ones.
Which is actually kind of exciting.
Yeah. It keeps things interesting.
And these 18 words, they're like a good foundation.
Like a base to build on.
Exactly. So where do we go from here? How can we keep practicing?
Well, the article suggests a few things. First, keep using the words.
In everyday conversations.
Yeah, like when you're talking to your friends or family.
Or even when you're reading.
Right. If you come across a health-related article, pay attention to the words they use.
And don't be afraid to look up words you don't know.
That's how we learn.
Exactly. And maybe watch a medical show.
With subtitles, of course.
So you can see how they use the words in context.
Right.
And, you know, thinking about the bigger picture.
It's really important to be able to talk about your health.
Especially in English.
Yeah, because if you can't explain how you're feeling,
it's hard to get the help you need.
Right, and it can be really frustrating.
And maybe even a little scary.
So by learning these words, you're taking control of your health.
You're advocating for yourself.
Exactly.
And that's empowering.
It is. So to wrap things up, I want to leave you with a challenge.
Oh, I love a challenge.
Think about all those situations where you might need to talk about your health.
Going to the doctor, going to the pharmacy.
Talking to your family.
Reading a health article.
Right, all those situations. And think about what words you would need to use.
Go beyond the 18 words we talked about.
Yeah, what other words might come in handy.
Write them down, look them up, try using them.
And remember, it's a journey.
Learning a language is a journey.
It's not about being perfect.
It's about progress.
It's about trying and learning and improving.
And having fun along the way.
Exactly. So keep learning, keep exploring, and we'll see you on our next deep dive.
Bye, everyone.